Hi there, I'm Andrea Koppel, and it's time for Coffee, the podcast where you get to hear firsthand what the jobs and careers that interest you the most are really like. Hey there, Java junkies. Welcome to another K-Cup mini episode of Time for Coffee. By the way, K-Cups come in three sizes, single, double, and triple shots, or roughly 1 minute, 5 minutes, or 10 minutes in length. So if you don't have time to throw back an entire caffeinated career conversation, these K-Cup mini episodes of T4C can give you a quick caffeinated fix, whether you're on the go or you only have a few minutes to binge. So grab your mug and take a chug, because it's time for a caffeinated career triple shot K-Cup with my guest, David Rosenstein. David, I want to talk a little bit about some of the internships that you had. One at Scholastic as a sales and marketing intern. I believe at Scholastic you worked under the umbrella of Scholastic, but you worked for Trade Klutz, which is such a great name. Another at HelloFresh US as a student consultant. And then lastly, at LinkedIn as a global sales intern. How did you get these internships?
Yeah, it's really, really a wonderful story for each of them. And the reality is, before I got the job at LinkedIn, HelloFresh wasn't even on my resume. The only thing that I had there was Scholastic. And I think sometimes when I speak with students, there's this boundary of, if I want to get an internship at this insane, insane company that feels like such a stretch away, whether for me, that was LinkedIn. For you, it might be the FBI or maybe a research lab that's incredibly competitive. You may think that you have to have the most outstanding, outstanding experience on your resume. And you may think that someone who has 10 other internships that show that they're way more qualified means that they're going to get it over you. But that just wasn't the case with me. So Scholastic, I was really lucky because I knew I was looking on LinkedIn and I realized that I knew someone who, one of our really good family friends, worked in a completely separate department at Scholastic. And so I asked him a little bit more about what it's like to work at the company that literally created my childhood. I mean, every single book fair. That was my entire elementary school.
Yep.
Yeah. And I got to ask him what the company looks like on the inside. He told me a bit about it and he let me speak with a couple of his teammates. And then that was that. But then I ended up applying. I really hit it off with the recruiter and one thing led to another. I spoke with the people at Trade Klutz, who are probably some of the most creative people I've ever met. And when I was speaking with them, it just became a really natural fit. So through the story with Scholastic, I was looking, it was March of my sophomore year. I had no internship. And so the first thing that I did was I asked, you know, who do I know who is at a company that I may even be remotely interested in? I wasn't asking for a job, but I simply asked, and I think, Andrea, you always talk about this. I didn't call him and ask, can I have an internship? But I asked him, I just said, hey, I want to learn a little bit more about what life is like at Scholastic. And through the questions and through the conversation, doors ended up opening. But it was through that initial looking into who do I already know? And so that was how Scholastic existed. As soon as I signed my offer for Scholastic, I was very laser focused on landing LinkedIn the next summer. I was very, very goal oriented and I didn't know anyone at LinkedIn. And so what did I do? I cold messaged every single intern who had just announced that they were starting in around May and said, hey, congratulations on starting at LinkedIn. I'm just so excited to follow your summer journey.
How did you find them? Sorry to interrupt, David, but how did you find those young people who had just signed on as interns?
Good question. A lot of people fail to realize that the LinkedIn search bar right up on top, it kind of operates like its own Google search engine within the LinkedIn ecosystem. So all I had to do was type in LinkedIn intern and I filtered present companies, people who work at LinkedIn. And sure enough, all of these people came up and a lot of them were software engineers. So I had to add marketing, sales, recruiting. And sure enough, a lot of different people appeared. And one person who responded, her name was Marin. She was incredibly talented and worked in inclusion recruiting. So I messaged her and said, hey, I'm just fascinated by what inclusion recruiting even is. Is it okay if one day after work, I call you to learn more about how you're job functions. And we had the most wonderful conversation. And I realized after that, she said, yeah, our job is mostly on the back end of HR, really on the recruiting strategy. I don't speak with students. And I thought, huh, that is awesome. And nothing that I want to do for the rest of my life. Right. Because I made it very clear. I said, look, the idea of recruiting excites me because I get to speak with people. And it doesn't sound like you do that in your job. So maybe you could help me as someone who does love speaking with people. Who would you recommend I speak with? And she said, oh, have you considered sales? And at that point, I really hadn't. But I said I'd be open to a conversation. That intro led me to the one person named Raza, who ended up being my champion throughout the whole interviewing process, gave me incredible perspective and ended up really cheering me on the entire way. So LinkedIn, one thing led to another. That was how I found that position and how that one intro turned into the job. And I'd be happy to talk about how the interview process went, but
oh yeah,
I know the actually, last thing that you meant.
Yeah. What I want you to talk about, because you did post about this on LinkedIn, or maybe it's on your, no, it's on your website.
Oh, I know.
You talk about how you used creativity. I mean, you used creativity to connect with all those people, first of all, but how you also used creativity to land the internship at LinkedIn.
Oh, yes. Well, this is probably the funniest story because I saw that the job posting became available. I wasn't expecting it. So rule of thumb, if you're speaking with someone who you know has internships, ask when they get posted. Because I wasn't ready. And one day I was on a bus coming back from a trip from New York. I saw that LinkedIn had posted their sales openings. I know for those tech companies, they may get 2,000 people apply in 1 week. So I had to act quickly. So I created a resume from scratch that looked like the LinkedIn homepage. I knew that I wanted to show that I'm really passionate about the product, about the company, and I want to go above and beyond. I was inspired by someone who applied to, I think, Twitter and Google and used either a Google homepage or a Twitter homepage as their resume. So I took a page out of that playbook. I made my resume that looked like a LinkedIn profile. I sent it to every person who I had developed a relationship with over the past 4 months. And fortunately, it got into the right eyes. And I actually got one recruiter reach out to me and say, you know, I worked at Disney and someone showed up to a career fair dressed as Cinderella. And this is up there with the most crazy things I've ever seen anyone do.
You were like, I will dress as a LinkedIn homepage. I don't care, whatever it takes, right?
I will. That will be my Halloween costume. I'm committed. I am sworn. Let's do it.
Oh my gosh. And yes, happy end to that story. But as you saw, there was still the coronavirus curveball. So David did get the internship. Sorry, he got the internship. And now he has leveraged that into the business leadership program, which has been postponed till the summer of 2021. Thanks for tuning in to this K-Cup mini episode of Time for Coffee. If you want to listen to our entire caffeinated career conversation, please check out the show notes for this episode.
Thanks so much for listening to Time for Coffee, where the professionals in the jobs that most interest you always have time to grab coffee 24/7, no matter where you live. I have one quick favor to ask you. Remember to rate, review, and subscribe to Time for Coffee. Thanks so much.